Hi, you're watching UseWise channel on YouTube. I'm Adriana Baranek, CEO of Miadria Group. We are continuing with our series on your email server and getting to know it. And here is my CTO, Mladen Baranek, the best person to answer all our questions. So if you go into email server and try to find out whether your email server is secure and if it is set up properly for the 21st century, DKIM is one of the terms that you will encounter. Can you tell us more about that?
So last time we spoke about sender policy framework that enables you to identify which email servers are allowed to send emails in name of your domain. Today we are discussing domain keys that can identify emails by sending digitally signed signature with an email that can be verified by using a public encryption key published through a DNS. So the idea is quite simple. Basically, you publish a public key on domain name system that everybody who receives email from you can check, and you sign your emails and attachments by your secret key that is known only to you, that means to the server that is sending emails in your name, and that gives you a guarantee that email was not modified on the way. Plus, if email is sent from a server that is used by many parties, it also adds additional verification to SPF, not only that the server was allowed to send an email in name of your domain, but that actually it used your secret key for signing attachments and email body, so that you can check it. Email was not modified. Usually today it is a transparent mechanism for the end user, but on the receiving side, if DKIM fails, you can specify what actions can should be taken. So we'll discuss that in our next video. So this is about DKIM.
Cool. And if someone is just an ordinary user and they want to check whether their email server does have DKIM, how would they do it?
So there are a number of tools that can provide verification whether your domain is using DKIM for sending emails, but you can also come to useways.com, log in with your corporate email address, and we'll check whether your email server is currently using DKIM and also the level of security of your server and some other parameters.
Yeah, and this service will be made available to you very soon. And one other question regarding DKIM, are all email servers capable of providing what is needed to implement DKIM?
Not really, but most modern servers can. Plus, services like G Suite or Office 365 can be used with DKIM, and I would say should be used with DKIM. It is also worth mentioning that at the same time you can have more than one DKIM, so it is possible to send emails from both G Suite and Office 365 and other servers with the digital signature. At the same time, for one domain or for subdomains.
And so basically the bottom line is, if you log in very soon on UseWise and you get a report where it says that your corporate email server does not support DKIM, you go to your IT manager and tell them that they should implement it, and they say, but our email server does not support it, then that is a very bad sign.
Yes, that means you are exposed to a number of frauds, and that the solution your enterprise is using is not really up to date.
Because we want to empower users to be able to go to their IT manager and to tell them that their email server needs to be upgraded. That is the bottom line, because that is not where your email is going through and how your email is being handled. It is part of your business. It is part of your business process. It is part of what you as a company are and how you represent yourself to the world. We want to give everyone the tool to make it possible to make that change in your company. Is it all that we have to say today about DKIM? Of course, this is a very huge topic, but we'll keep it short.
Well, for today, that's enough.
Yeah, thank you so much,
Martin. Thank you.
Thank you, and have a great day, and we will see you very soon. Thank you. Bye.